But I can sing a song. you can sing this song when I'm gone.
Blossom of snow may bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever. Edelweiss, Edelweiss, bless my homeland forever.
I am Tim's older brother, and I am just so excited to be here with you all. We are so happy for Tim and Becca. I just want to thank you all for coming and joining us in this super happy occasion. I also want to thank Jim and Brenda and John and Cindy for their huge contributions in these two lives. Tim and Becca would not be here without all of the love and support they've gotten from their parents, everything from scraped knees and bruised elbows to college classes and big, huge life decisions that I know they've sought your advice on. So we also just want to honor the parents in this occasion too. So as Tim's older brother, I've known him a long time, you know, his whole life. And there's just been, you know, countless hours and days spent together, and it's just been such a wonderful time. One of our favorite stories is kind of legendary. Is this one time when I was, you know, about five, and Tim was about three, and I had this thing for trains. So I used to play train all the time. I'd line up all the chairs in the house, and I would get up front, and I would drive that train. So one time I was busy driving my train, and I looked behind me. And I'm there with my little like stacking ring as a steering wheel, because you have a steering wheel on a train. And Tim is steering the train too with his stacking ring. And I told him to eat the donut while I drove the train. And obviously that was influential because we're still having donuts for dessert tonight. But on a more serious note, it's just been such an honor to grow up with Tim. I've spent so much time with him, from being on the same track team and running a business together and looking for 57s everywhere we go, taking classes, listening to the same music. We've done so much together, and it's just been great to grow up with him and watch him become the man he is and the way he's inspired me too. And then I remember the time that I was in Connecticut and I got this phone call from Tim, and he told me about this girl and grad school class that he asked on a date, and she was really awesome. And he was so excited me to tell me about Becca. Then I came out to Colorado shortly after that, and I met her on top of a mountain, and I couldn't help but see why Tim fell for her. Becca, you are a delight to be around. You just light up the room, and you have such a great laugh, and you're just so much fun to be around. So it's no wonder that Tim was immediately taken by you. And it's just been, it's been great to see the way you two, already very mature individuals, have just grown even more together. The way you challenge each other, and the way you encourage each other, and the way you just, you put each other first, and you really model Christ in the way that you love one another. And that's so encouraging to us all. As we saw from their experiment during their wedding, this is one occasion where 1 + 1 does not equal 2. These two together are so much more than their parts. They are going to be such a huge force in the world, and I know that they're going to do such amazing things together, more than either one of them could do separately, something that they can only do together and with God as they follow him in their life. Kind of what I've been thinking about as I've thought about Tim and Becca, and what keeps coming back to me is like, these are two people who are going places. I mean that in a lot of ways. Not only have they been across the world, Tim to Africa, but both of them to Africa to work in developing communities, but I've seen them on both coasts. I've seen them in the mountains. I've seen them by the ocean in Galveston. and I know no matter where they are, no matter where they go, that they will make it work. They will make their mark on their community. Community is something that's so important to them. And it's just, it's so great to see that about them. So, I know all of this is possible because of God, and that their whole point is to bring glory to God through Jesus and empowered by the Holy Spirit. So I just want us all to lift our glasses to a happy and joyous life filled with wondrous love and adventures to Tim and Becca.
So I didn't write anything down. Because I was speaking at the wedding. And I was like, this is all I have time to focus on. But I knew that I could talk about Becca all day long, because that's all I ever do. Whenever I meet someone, I just talk about you. I'm like, whenever they say, like, well, I know this really smart person, Sasha said this too. I'm like, yeah, well, my sister's smart. Like, she's so awesome. So, I love you, Becca. So, Lachlan, you're my first child, but Becca kind of felt like my first child. Because I was 4 when you were born. And I was kind of like, every 4-year-old's dream is just like, they have a little doll and they're like pushing it around. I'm like, I have a real baby now. Like, this is my baby. Like, sorry, Mom, but like, I thought she was mine. Like, I'm sure you were like, yes, okay, too, because you're so nice to me. So, I just grew up loving her so much. I love you. I'm so happy today. I just keep thinking of you when you're just so tiny and little, and this is just the best day ever, and it's like, it's almost like the second best day of my life. You know, it's like, and my wedding day, and then it's your wedding day. It's so special. I love you. So, I have to say something else. I thought of things. I don't think of things. So I kind of grew up wanting to protect Becca. Like, I wanted to teach her. Like, I really did, like, feel like I wanted anything that I went through, like, I wanted to protect her from it. I wanted to, like, show her any, like, any pain that I went through. I wanted her not to experience that, you know? Like, I wanted to teach her all the things about junior high or high school or anything that, like, had shocked me or bothered me. Like, I really wanted that. And so I, you know, I did my best to do that all through high school, but then I left for college, and then I actually hit, like, a really hard time in my life. And I started needing Becca all the time, and that was, like, a huge shift in our relationship. And she was there for me through everything, and I'm so thankful for that. And I'm so glad that that time happened, because I felt like our relationship evened out so much, and then you could kind of like know me and like my struggles too. And then we were just like, I think our friendship, like, it really just grew in that time. But then somehow, like, God just led me out of that time where I was just like struggling and like running away from him and like suffering a lot because of that. And somehow, like, I'm so happy that he kind of gave me the big sister role again by just letting me get married, like, before you. Not in, like, a way, like, I got married first. But just, but just, like, I feel like any wisdom that I've ever been able to share with you is not from me, you know? It's just through that process of, you know, God teaching me through marriage. And I'm just so thankful to have that now again, and just, it's really exciting for me to have just recently gotten married and then see you and just know that it's going to be so joyful for you. And Tim, oh, I got that same email with the video of you playing guitar before they had talked. He did it. He sang a song in the class. Yeah, so I got that same email, and I give you a thumbs up, by the way, right offhand. I was just like, yes, Becca, this is good. you know, and then I heard all of the, you know, the ups and, well, the up and the down, and then now we're on the up again, right? So it's not that complicated, really, but I just have to say that Tim, I just love you. I just really love you already. Like, I'm not like, well, I kind of, you know, it's just like, I'm just 100% there, and that was just so fast. I feel like, I'm just like, whoa, that was easy. Like, you're just good, you know? But I guess that amazes me because of my protective nature towards my sister. Like, that's been, I mean, I've had such a strong nature for that, but it's like somehow I knew that, like Dave said, you pursuing Christ, like, in your relationship and like following God was, I knew you were safe because of that, no matter what. And so that always gave me peace. But on top of that, there's just something special about Tim. Like, just something really special about him. And like, meeting his family really like brought all of that out. And I'm just really thankful to have met all of you. And I am like, I think of you as my family too now. I know it doesn't like count that way, technically, but I'm kind of like taking you for myself too. So I'm so excited for this day and so excited for your marriage, and you are the loveliest people in the world. I love you guys. Cheers.
Say hey, everybody.
Hey!
Hey! Hey. Say hey, guys.
Are you going to follow behind?
Yeah, no.